That's not it. Guys, I've been looking everywhere for these plans. I've been working very hard on some master plans for something I'm creating. But guess what? No matter how hard I work, I always seem to mess up my plans. They're never exactly perfect. Sometimes I measure wrong, and sometimes I don't draw things correctly, and sometimes it just doesn't turn out according to what I picture in my head. But guess what? Do you know that our God, He is the perfect creator and designer, and He never messes up. He designed you. Yes, you. Look around at your friends right now. He designed them too. Every single part of us, He knows through and through. Every single day, I tell my family, and I always try to remind myself too, guys, God made us, and He loves us, and He always, always knows what's best for us. And that includes every detail of your life, from what happened when you got up this morning, to what happens before you go to bed, from what you look like to the friends that you have. He knows you through and through. And so today we're going to look at a story from Mark chapter 11. And I want you to stick with me because we're going to look for some details. And while I'm telling you this story, I want you to see if you can notice an animal and some people and some clothing, okay? Because this is what we're going to talk about at the end, all right? So here we go. But before I start, please remember that you're a part of God's plans too. Here we go. Jesus is with His disciples, and they're near Jerusalem and a mountain called the Mount of Olives. And He takes two of them. Count with me. One, two. He sends two of His disciples to go to a village. And He says, here's what's going to happen. When you get to the village, you're going to see a donkey. There's your animal, a donkey. And he's going to be tied up, and I want you to untie him and bring him to me. And some people, if they say to you, hey, why are you taking our donkey? Or why are you taking that donkey? You should say to them, the Lord needs it, and He'll return it immediately. Can you guys do this with me? Make an L. Say, the Lord needs it. That's right, He did. And exactly what Jesus said would happen did happen. They took that donkey that the Lord needed. They brought it back to Jesus. They took off their cloaks. You probably don't have a cloak on, do you? I have on a sweater. Maybe you have on a jacket or something. That's pretty similar. They took it off and they laid it on top of the donkey, and Jesus sat down on the donkey. And then as they were going, something totally awesome happened. All the people around them, they took off their cloaks and they were laying them down in the path that the donkey was going on. And they were also laying down palm branches, like leafy, big green leaves, and they were putting them there. And they were also waving them, and they were shouting something. Do you know what they were shouting? They were shouting, Hosanna! Can you guys say the word Hosanna? Ready, set, go. Hosanna! Good job. They were saying, Hosanna! Blessed is He who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the coming kingdom of David. Hosanna in the highest. And so Jesus went on this path that they'd created with their cloaks and with the branches, and He went to the temple and He looked around. And then it was kind of late, so He and His disciples, all 12 of them, went to Bethany. And that's the end of our story today. But guys, did you notice the things I asked you to notice? Did you notice the people, the two disciples and the 12 disciples and Jesus? Did you notice the animal? What was the animal? Can you say it out loud? Ready, set, go. It was a donkey or a colt. And did you notice the clothing? What was the clothing? A cloak. Not just one, but many. God used all of these details to work together this story for His glory. Because in a few weeks, guess what's going to happen? Jesus is going to die on the cross. And He's going to be buried and rise again. And we already know that. But this was before it happened. And so Jesus, here today, he hears the people saying, Hosanna, which means save us. We need you. Rescue us, God. And He hears that. And what you need to know is that Jesus is worthy of all that praise and more than we could ever give. And God in His kindness works out every detail in this story. And God in His kindness knit you together and created you and has a plan for your life just like He has a plan for all things. He is the perfect designer and the perfect creator. And we were made to be people who say to Him, Hosanna, we need you, because you and I, we're sinners and we can't save ourselves, but Jesus can. He is the Savior of the world. And let's worship Him together and shout Hosanna together. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans for welfare and not for evil, to give you a future and a hope. Jeremiah 29:11.